especially about Alzheimer's disease, that there are probably more studies because it's such an important disease. It causes so much suffering and so much cost in society. There are more studies, and we know that women are more prone to develop Alzheimer's disease. And the idea was that maybe it was because they live longer, so it's more frequent to develop the dementia, and in particular Alzheimer's disease. But now we know that this is not enough, and it's probably also a hormonal effect, that especially after menopause, that estrogens are decreased. This could play a role in the vulnerability of women for Alzheimer's disease. So maybe their brain is more vulnerable due to the decrease of estrogen. But it's interesting because we know that there is local estrogen production also in the brain. So the brain can produce estrogen even in menopause, even in men. And if we can find treatments that they can maybe increase locally these estrogens and other neurosteroids, this could also be a target for the treatment of dementia. I know that there are some studies on that. In my lab, we mostly design experiments to see if this local estrogen production could have an effect in stress response and depression. But there are also studies, and with my collaborator, Dr. Ioannis Sotiropoulos in Portugal, and there are studies that we have shown that maybe there is some common mechanism between depression and Alzheimer's disease. So maybe the chronic stress exposure could predispose people to Alzheimer's disease and depression. So some of the neurobiology could be the same, and maybe sex differences could also be relevant in both diseases, as women are more prone in both depression and Alzheimer's disease. So this is something that we need to take into consideration, but there are not very many studies on that.